Hey, what you say, food family? Mike here, and welcome back to the channel for another great culinary adventure. Today's video, we're headed to the island nation of the Philippines to create a simple yet satisfying noodle stir-fry dish called Pancit Bihon. We're going to grab some veggies from the fridge, saute those up and paired with some noodles and cabbage, make a simple sauce, and then you can add any protein of choice, beef, chicken, or pork, and you're eating good. So whether you're new to Filipino cuisine or just want to add a new stir-fry to your repertoire, stick around and I'll show you how it's done. Let's get cooking! Alright folks, we'll get today's video kicked off by talking about our protein. Now, like I said in the introduction, Pancit Bihon can be paired with any protein of choice, beef, chicken, or pork. And I've been fortunate enough to do some traveling around the Philippines. I did whitewater rafting in Mindanao, went scuba diving in Boracay, and then some general backpacking and sightseeing in the Manila area. And the common theme was chicken. Everywhere you look, every corner, every street, every alley, there's chickens and roosters all over the damn place, crowing before the sun even comes up while you're trying to nurse a cheap whiskey hangover. And I think that's exactly why Filipinos love eating chicken, because those damn things are annoying. So like I said, we're going to be cooking chicken today for our Pancit Bihon. So as you see in front of me here, I got some chicken thighs. We're going to do a real simple method today. We're just going to boil these in some chicken stock. We're going to boil them for about 10 to 12 minutes just to get them basically cooked. Let those cool, chop them up, and then we're going to be pan frying these a little bit later. So right now, we'll just get started with that. So let me get these boiled 10 to 12 minutes. We'll come right back for the next step. All right, folks, just like that, we boiled our chicken for about 10 to 12 minutes or so, just sort of basically get it cooked through. And we'll set this in a bowl off to the side here and just let these cool for a bit while we move on with the rest of the recipe. Now, I still got my chicken stock here. It's still hot in front of me. So today we're going to be using these noodles. Now, these are actually Pancit Bihon noodles. Pancit itself is derived from quick and easy and convenient, hence the stir fry part of this recipe. Bihon is this actual vermicelli noodle itself, rice noodle. Nothing fancy here. You can find this at any market, any Asian market for sure, but most regular grocery stores carry this as well. You don't really have to cook these a long time. We're just basically going to dip these in this hot chicken stock, pull them back out, set them off to the side for a little bit. So let me get these dipped, let them soak 3 or 4 minutes in this hot chicken stock, and we'll be right back. All right, fun fact, folks. When you're not cooking this for a video like I am today, use a bigger pot so it all fits in there. Ended up splitting it in half. But basically, you want to cook these noodles or let them soak in that hot chicken stock just until they're falling apart. You know, it's not all crispy and crunchy. They're fairly soft, but not super soft yet. Well, these still got a little bit of cooking to do, so we don't want to overcook them. You want to leave some bite to them. These should be like super al dente, probably halfway cooked to what you want your final noodle texture to be. So you know, we got these, we can set these off to the side for a second. And now we're gonna go in, using our same chicken stock still, and cook our cabbage. So I'm gonna bring this back up to a boil, throw the cabbage in for 4 or 5 minutes, just so it softens up and gets nice and tender, and we'll be right back. Folks, we got our cabbage out of our chicken stock. I let that boil and steam in that pot for about 4 to 6 minutes. Now, I like my cabbage more on the crisp, crunchy side, so I stopped it around the 4 or 5 minute mark. If you like yours a little softer, maybe go 6, 7, even up to 8 minutes. You don't want to overcook it, though. We're still not quite done with our cooking part of this recipe. So now we got our cabbage strained from our chicken stock. Believe it or not, we're finally done with this chicken stock. We got our money's worth of that today, right? Now, I'm going to take these noodles that we are basically half cooked and toss them in with this cabbage, probably a little at a time since I like to put way too much stuff in a bowl at once and make a giant mess here. We'll start with that. And then just toss those around, and the heat of the cabbage will finish cooking our noodles off pretty much for us. Everything will be going in a pan and getting sauteed and stir-fried, but we just want to get a little more help here. And I am making a larger batch than normal. I will link the recipe in the description below for probably a human-sized version of this, not a small army. But hey, it's noodles, cabbage. It's healthy, right? Make a big batch. All right, so I'm going to get this tossed together, and we'll set this aside. I'll get this chicken stock stuff cleaned up. We'll be right back for the final step. We can start putting everything together with the rest of our veggies. Stay tuned. All right, folks, we got everything cleaned up. Our noodles and cabbage are combined together. I just got them sitting in a bowl off to the side while we turn our attention to the rest of the recipe. Now, this next step's a little bit controversial depending on whether you're a Filipino or anyone else in the world. We're going to heat some olive oil up and cook some onions and garlic. Now, if you're Filipino, you're going to go oil, garlic for a minute or two, and then add your onions for 3 or 4 minutes. I tend to think the garlic gets overcooked, burned, and a little bitter in that method, so I'm going to go heat the olive oil, throw my onions in for 3 or 4 minutes till they start to soften up and become translucent, then toss in my fresh chopped garlic for the last minute or so till it becomes fragrant. At that point, we'll go in with our chicken that we boiled earlier. I just went ahead and chopped it up into bite-sized pieces, seasoned that with salt and pepper. So let's get this first part cooked up, and I'll be right back. Folks, we got our onions and garlic sauteed up, added that chicken we cooked earlier. It is looking and smelling absolutely delicious so far, but we're only halfway through. So now we can go in with the rest of our veggies. Now, like I said in the introduction of the video, this is a catch-all meal. You can add any sort of veggies you got in the fridge that are about to go bad or you want to use up. Perfect place to use them in this recipe here. So today I'm going in with shredded carrots and snow peas, but feel free to add broccoli, celery, green beans, bamboo shoots, whatever you would find in a normal stir fry. It fits perfectly in here. Great way to add veggies to your diet, a little more fiber, sneak them in on the kids if they're not paying attention. They're going to love it. So that being said, anyway, let's get this stuff cooked up. I'm going to add our carrots and snow peas, let those saute a few minutes, start to warm up and soften, and we're going to season this today with some soy sauce and some oyster sauce. Now, if you're new to stir fries or you haven't been around very long, oyster sauce is the king of flavors when it comes to umami and stir fries. You cannot beat it. It does not taste like oysters by any means. I don't know how they make it, whatever, but it's absolutely amazing. Great flavor. You can pick this up at any local grocery store, any Asian market, of course, but go to Walmart, whatever. They're going to have this oyster sauce in that Asian aisle section. Absolutely amazing. You don't want to skip it. Great flavor. Zero effort. So let's get this stuff sauteed up, and we'll be right back to combine it with our noodles and cabbage. Stay tuned. Alright folks, you saw in the previous clip, we got our veggies sauteed up, finished off the stir fry portion of this, and we'll go ahead and apologize in advance. I got about halfway through that last portion and realized I didn't hit record on the camera, so you missed out, but like I said previously, all we did was add the carrots and the snow peas, mixed it all together, stir fried it together for 2-3 minutes just to heat everything up, added the soy sauce and the oyster sauce, and let that stir fry together, saute for about 4 or 5 minutes just to finish things off. Now, normally at this point, we're going to take all of our stir fry saute veggie mixture here with the chicken and add that to our noodles and cabbage or vice versa. But obviously I made a giant batch here today for a big meal prep, so I'm not gonna be able to combine that together in a single pan. But at home when you're cooking this, just go ahead and take your noodles and cabbage, add it to your pan you sauteed with all those veggies and the oyster sauce and everything. Let those soak up those flavors a little better and warm back up. But today I got a little bowl here. We'll just make a little mini prep version. So I got my noodles and cabbage. Let's grab some of our saute veggies and that chicken with that sauce. All right, toss that around. Now we're going to finish this off with some fresh cilantro. And I love cilantro, but by all means, if you're one of those weirdos out there that thinks it tastes like soap, leave it out. Other than that, one final drizzle of sesame oil. And voila, we got our Pancit Bihon with chicken. Let me get this cleaned up, plated up. We'll come back, give it a taste test, and see how we did. Well, Well, folks, just like that, we have made Pancit Bihon with chicken. It is looking and smelling absolutely amazing, but that's only half the battle. Let's dig in and see what it tastes like. Now, I plated it up all nice and pretty here. I had some lemon slices. I'm not going to bother squeezing those on there. We got that sesame oil, that fresh cilantro mixed in. Should be enough for today. So I'm going to go ahead and start with the noodles. Perfectly cooked, soft, still got some bite to it, got some texture there. Soaked up the flavors of that sesame oil and the oyster sauce and soy sauce we put in with the stir-fry veggies and everything. Really good. You don't want to overcook those. They will turn to mush and fall apart real easy on you, though, so be careful. If anything, lean towards the more al dente side. You can always heat this back up, and it'll finish cooking the noodles a little bit later on. Other than that, noodles are perfect. Let's go in with some of the chicken. Chicken thighs just can't be beat, folks. You really can't overcook them and mess them up. Now, today we cooked these twice. We boiled them first to get them cooked, and then we sauteed them in with the veggies in the pan. Now, that actually kind of sealed in those juices and seared the outside. Made for a nice texture. You got a crispy, almost crunch exterior without any breading or anything, and then the inside is nice and moist and tender. Absolutely amazing. But like I said earlier in the recipe or in the video, you can use this with pork. You can do pork belly, ground pork, beef strips, like a sliced sirloin or ribeye or something. It would work just the same and taste absolutely amazing. I'm going to go with some of these veggies. I got onions in here today, carrots, those snap peas. Those veggies are where it's at, folks. Nice, crispy, juicy, still tender, of course. We got them cooked and sauteed long enough so they're not hard and crunchy, but nice bite to them. I don't know if you heard the crunch when I took my bite, but so good. Nice sweetness to it, subtle hint of sweetness in there. Then that oyster sauce and soy sauce bring that salty umami flavor there. Really rounds out. All together, folks, you know, you got some noodles in here, piece of chicken, some of that cabbage. Now, of course, you can cook your cabbage more or less depending on how you prefer it. Let me get one last bite. Absolutely delicious, folks. The noodles, the chicken, the veggies, everything all comes together. It's such a wonderful bite. This is a sleeper when it comes to Filipino food, folks. Everybody talks about lumpia or lechon kawali, crispy fried pork bellies, you know, things like that, normal Filipino food. It's not well known around the world, but I'm telling you what, this one right here, you should give it a try. This is a simple stir fry that anyone can make at home. Basic ingredients, using up stuff you got in the fridge. Do whatever you want to do with it. Soy sauce and oyster sauce, the seasoning, it can't get any easier, folks. I'll be sure to link the recipe in the description below. That'll send you my website, www.grubongrub.com. A lot of other great recipes on there. Check it out. Got the recipe card with times, amounts, descriptions, everything you need to know to recreate today's meal. And if you enjoyed this type of video today, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Hit that like button, folks. That tells me this is the type of content you want to see more of. Let me know in the comments below. Leave a comment. Should I cook more Filipino food? I'm not real well versed in it by any means, but I love experimenting with new stuff. If you want to see that, be sure to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so YouTube will send you a reminder next time I put out a great video just like this one. Other than that, folks, it's been a pleasure cooking for you once again. Mike here signing off. Till next time, just keep cooking.